Hello guys, welcome to another Few Money. I know that I have not been here for a few days, so the last time I recorded the video was on Saturday, past Saturday, and on Sunday I just published a small part of that live stream that we made on Saturday, because it contains 10 minutes with my take on what's going on in El Salvador and the approval of the Bitcoin law and all that has been involved or could be involved in the future. So since Sunday, you have not been seeing any videos from me. I had strong personal reasons not to record any videos. I was not in the right mood, let's put it like that. And now finally, I am back to the videos today, Thursday, and we are going to check Bitcoin again, as usual during the week, with a small update on the price action. So let's go directly to the screen share. And before I just start with the screen share, I just want you guys to know that we have a Telegram group now, so it's not just Twitter, my account on Twitter and the YouTube account also for the videos, but we also have a Telegram group, which will show up in a second here on the screen. So you guys can join this Telegram group, participate in the debate, talk about Bitcoin and the markets in general, and you can also get access to more direct posts from me and from everyone else inside the group. We have now achieved more than 100 people there. In the last few days, we had a few more joining, so we are now more than 100 people on the Telegram group, and of course, we are waiting for you guys there if you are have not subscribed yet. Also, if you enjoy the content in this channel, gently touch the like button, subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends. Of course, don't forget to touch the also to gently touch the bell icon and select all so that you can get all the notifications as soon as a video is uploaded. Okay guys, so let's go to the price to time model. There's been a slight update that as I have not been here for the last few days since Sunday, we could see a bit of a difference from the last videos. So here it is, the price of time model still on top of the 2017 cycle. I guess it will not be easy either way, or to go ahead of the 2017 cycle or delayed regarding that cycle, which is of course this yellow candle pattern you guys see here on the price of time model. So what I'm talking about is if the price action regarding time and price level goes to the right side of the 2017 cycle, we are a bit delayed as compared to that cycle. If, however, the price action goes above this 2017 cycle and continues on the left side of the candle pattern, we are ahead of time regarding the top, the possible top for the end of this year. So far, everything is very undecided because we have been on top of this yellow candle pattern for the last 1 or 2 weeks. So no one still knows what's going to happen, if we are going to go to the right side of the candle pattern and be delayed, or to the left side and be ahead of time. However, everything is still on track. As you guys can see, comparing to the 2017 cycle, we are still on track to achieve a top this year. However, due to this big correction we had from the 64.5K to 30K recently, I believe that we could be extended a bit in time and probably have the top not by October, but possibly closer to the end of the year or even in the first 1 or 2 months of 2022. So if that is the case, of course, the price to time model was pointing for a top around mid October, beginning of October, or the last half of October. I don't know if this is still possible. However, we are still on track to do that. Let's see how the price action evolves for the next few weeks. And of course, every time there's a big change, I will tell you guys about it. So that's it about the price action on the price to time model. And we can, of course, check the RSI, which is a weekly RSI. As you guys know, the price to time model is a weekly chart. And here it is, one change that we had since the last few videos, we have touched again the orange dashed line. That, as a few of you guys already know, as I've been discussing this, this is the level of the RSI after the mid cycle top, so the local top of 2013, after the big correction of 75% before starting the second leg to the real top of 2013. So this is the RSI level of that mid top that we had in 2013, and we are now touching that line. So that's somewhat good news, and I believe that every day that goes by, the bottom, the possible bottom around 30k is in. So I am more and more convinced that we could have this bottom around 30k, and from here start a new bullish trend. I'm not saying that it's going to go to the top tomorrow, but I'm going to say that I foresee some kind of consolidation still for the few weeks ahead, and slowly and gradually we will continue our path to a more bullish price action and structure of the price also. So let's see what happens. So regarding the price to time model, that's what I have for you guys today, and I'm going to go to the MRI strategy, my second chart, always as usual, and start with the weekly. So the weekly has been having a good rise on the price action for this MRI bottom week, which is the green candle you guys see here. So this is the MRI bottom candle. You guys see the green arrow pointing up and the number one. So this is the MRI saying that possibly the bottom is in, and this is the candle that will reverse the price action. However, since the week started, we have been some difficulties. We had a few difficulties overcoming the trend line. The second trend line that you guys know already from my analysis is here, and it's not been easy for Bitcoin price action to overcome that trend line. So we went up, so we had a number two above, a green two above the green one, but now we are just at the same level-ish of the previous candle close. So everything still also a bit undecided on what's going to happen, but it's a good sign that for the MRI bottom we had this increase in the price, and this gives us at least some kind of hope that the bottom might be in. And I, as you guys know already since last week, I said that I'm already in the one digit percentage probabilities that we have not found the bottom yet. So this is less than 10%, and for me it's 90% or a bit more that the bottom is in around the 30k. However, there's still that small probability that it, you know, I've been here for a few years, so I'm used to have small probabilities occurring in Bitcoin. So it's still possible that we could see a new low below the 30k level, but I would say it's becoming more and more less probable to happen. So regarding the weekly chart, that's what I've been watching. We are finally also outside of the triangle, so we broke out of the triangle by the end of last week, and that's also a good sign. The RSI is going sideways. Let me just zoom in here for you guys. The RSI is just in the middle territory, just going sideways, not doing anything, because this week has been very, you know, going up, coming down, going up, coming down. So it's just a small zigzag in the accumulation area. No big deal. There is no big action in the price since we started the week on Monday. So the RSI is reflecting exactly that. The MACD continues to be bearish. But as you guys know, the MACD is a bit of a laggy indicator. So we, however, have two light red bars already, and the blue line is showing signs of starting to go horizontal. Very small signs, but you can see it already if you really zoom in. So that's the outlook for the weekly right now. So let's see the daily and check how this is. So here it is. the breakout of the triangle, which occurred on the last 13th of June, just a few days ago, 4 days ago, and with a green bi-signal star, which is, of course, a good sign also. So we broke out of the triangle on the daily, we went up, and we hit my trend line. And an indication that this trend line is actually becoming relevant is the fact that it held the price after the first big drop. It held the price for a few days, and only after a few days it was broken to the downside. Then we went back up above the trend line again. It held the price for 3 or 4 more days. Then we went down, and now that trend line became resistance. We have the resistance here. When we tried to break the triangle for the first time, actually we tried there, but here we were still not touching the top of the triangle. And here on this candle, you have actually the candle touches the top of the triangle and the trend line at the same time. So I said that by that time that it would be very, very hard for the price action of Bitcoin to break out of the triangle here, because we had too many factors making resistance to the price action going to the upside. And one of them was the top of the triangle, also the trend line, and also the 20 period SMA, which was coming down in a fury, and all of them were crossing the same area of the chart. So it was a bit obvious that we would continue going down and retest the bottom of the triangle before a new leg up. So finally, we broke the top of the triangle, we went up to the trend line, and now we have been rejected. And there is also on the daily something which I don't really like, which is an MRI top. So we have an MRI top, although this was not on that candle, the reversal candle. This is 2 candles after, so 2 days after the actual resistance of the trend line and rejection of the price action on that trend line. But this is still an MRI top. I don't see it as a very, very strong MRI top. I would see it as very strong if this was 2 days ago in this candle here, the red candle just below that tried to pass, overcome this trend line. But however, this is still an MRI top. So we should respect the indicator and probably wait for some kind of retracement. And if that happens, I see it revisiting this top of the triangle here and finding support not only on the top of the triangle, but also on the 20 period SMA, which is coming now back to coming out of the triangle also, and going a bit more steep than just sideways, just a few degrees of inclination going up already. And probably if we have some kind of retracement today, we will find support on the top of the triangle, retest the triangle, find support on the 20 period SMA, and probably have a reversal of the price action after this MRI top. However, there is also the probability that this MRI top gives us 4 more days of downside. So I would not be jumping around already or, telling everyone what a millionaire you are going to become really soon, because we might still go down for this MRI top and have a 4-day retracement, retesting the top of the triangle, probably continuing with some more accumulation. And then after some time, which I foresee could be several weeks, we could finally start to go up in a real price action reversal. So let's see how this evolves. But that's my take on the daily chart. The RSI also in the middle territory. However, the MACD is bullish on the daily, which is a good sign. We are having some days already, a few days already of bullish action on the MACD, sorry. And let's see how that evolves. But I am very happy already that we left the triangle. Sorry for that. We left the triangle and we are now trying to break resistance after resistance going up again. So it might take some time, but I believe that the bottom is in. Just a small probability that this is not true, but I believe the bottom is in and we are going to continue up in a gradual and sustainable way. Let's just check the 4-hour chart and see how the BitMEX funding rate is. So this is now favoring the bulls. The BitMEX funding rate on the 4-hour is, as you guys can see, negative. The premium is also negative and the level is below my green threshold, The green threshold, as you guys know, it's to the downside. So this is now around minus 0.076. So that's favoring the bulls for sure. And probably that's what's been keeping us from continuing to go down for this MRI top and favoring the price action, you know, giving strength to the bulls to maintain the price at least maintaining the price at the same levels as we have been since the beginning of today. So that's it for the 4 hour. No big deal here. All the moving averages except the 20 period are below the price action, which is also very good for the short term, you know, development of what might happen. So that's it for the 4 hour. Let me just confirm on the 1 hour how the BitMEX funding rate is. And I would like to not take too long on the charts because I have something else I want to tell you guys and show you guys. So the 1 hour shows exactly the same. Minus 0.081, so it's almost the same level, just to confirm that this is correct and a shorter time frame is more accurate. So here you are, that's what's happening. So I just wanted to show you guys this. This is of course something I hate, I don't like it. We had an MRI bottom on the dollar, the Dixie index, the DXY, which is the index of the dollar against all other currencies in the world. And the dollar is becoming very, very strong here, hitting resistance of the 50 period SMA on the weekly. So we had an MRI bottom. I was expecting this MRI bottom not to be so strong as it is showing now this week, because the previous week we just went up just a little bit as compared. We did not even close the candle above the previous high of the week before. So actually, I was not expecting this rise, this big rise in the price of the dollar against all other currencies. Probably this happened because of yesterday. You guys know we had the Fed, the meeting of the Fed. And of course, as those guys continue to lie and deceive everyone, saying that there is no inflation and that they are taking all the measures necessary to stop inflation, I guess probably this made the dollar go up all this since the beginning of yesterday, I guess, because the dollar was not so high yesterday. I checked it and this was not that high. And so since that meeting happened yesterday, I guess that the dollar jumped in the price against all other currencies. But I hope this 50 period SMA that is coming down here will make big resistance to this rise of the dollar price and send it back down soon, because what we need is the dollar to go below 89 to break this big support that it's been holding the price for so long already, so many weeks. And we need the dollar to go below 89. So that's it for the dollar. Another big move is this. I was not expecting this in gold. I told you guys that I was expecting a small retracement. Let me just reload this because I cannot see the MRI working. Okay, now we have the MRI. So you guys can see that we had an MRI top exactly there on that candle. And this was very accurate of this indicator to show us the MRI top. And then I said that I was expecting a few weeks of downside, but probably finding support on the 50 period SMA, which is the yellow line. And as you guys know, because if you have checked gold already, gold has been dropping like crazy today. And I guess this is the inverse correlation between gold and the dollar. Of course, people were buying gold because of they were afraid of the inflation that was rising and rising with the dollar. But now that the Fed lied to everyone, big, big, big lie, saying that there is no inflation and that they are fighting the inflation and taking all the measures to stop it. Of course, people are now selling some gold, and that's what's happening in real time. You can even see the candle going down. So this is what lies coming from the Fed do to the markets. Of course, Peter Schiff should be really, really pissed off because of this big drop in gold. And even worse, because this comes from a big lie that everyone was told yesterday after the meeting at the Fed. So that's gold for you, of course. Also, another thing that has been showing some differences from, sorry, not this, some differences from the last time I recorded the video is the S&P 500. We achieved a new all-time high there, so this was even above the MRI top. However, since the week started, actually since yesterday we have been going down. Of course, this is the weekly candle, but since yesterday we have been going down, and now we are below the previous candle opening, and that's an engulfing candle. So I don't like it very much, but I don't see the S&P going to do the same as gold, of course, because gold has been used for a long time already, has been used all since the first impressions of the hyperinflation started. And now, as people got lied to, I guess they are selling gold because they don't believe so much in the hyperinflation that is actually coming. And the S&P is not going to suffer so much as gold. I don't see it coming back down in that big move like gold did, because the S&P, I believe, in my personal opinion, that it's not used as a hedge against inflation as much as gold. So that's it for the S&P. And we are already overextended in time, so guys, I'm sorry for that. But after not being recording videos for so many days, 3 days, I think that you deserved a bit in-depth analysis of what's happening and the big differences between the last week and this week. So that's it for me today. I hope you guys are okay and everything is going fine with you. Let me just stop screen share. And just coming back to the main screen. So, of course, guys, if you enjoyed the content, of course, don't forget to gently touch the like button as usual and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to share, to subscribe to the channel if you are new, and share it with your friends. And also don't forget that we have, let me just put it on the screen again, we have a Telegram group right now where, of course, I communicate with everyone, and I usually am more active on the Telegram group, and I use Twitter just to make some important announcements, but usually I use the Telegram group to communicate with everyone that follows the channel. So anything new, or any, imagine I can't do a video, for example, tomorrow, I will go to Telegram group and tell everyone the reasons why I will not have a video tomorrow, for example. Or if something really extraordinary happens in the markets, the Telegram group will be always the first to know. So don't forget to subscribe to the Telegram group. It's right here on the screen. You just have to go to a browser and write t.me/fumoney, or you can even use the Telegram app to search for FU Money, and it will show it to you right on top. So join us there and be always updated of what's happening with the FU Money channel and me and everyone in that group. Of course, we are a very close community. So join us and be always informed. Okay, guys, so that's it. Don't forget, I will be here tomorrow again with another video, and the live streams are on Saturdays. So I guess have a nice day, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.